I've been watching the local coverage of the protests in St. Louis over the not guilty verdict of a white police officer accused of shooting a black motorist back in 2011. This edition of alleged bad cop versus innocent citizen protest seems to be going down a totally different path than St. Louis' previous riot-torn explosion called Ferguson. What's different? Well, everything, except the base facts. In both cases, a white police officer shot and killed a black citizen. One side believes the aggrieved victims were mostly innocent and profiled based on their race. Another side feels the cops were permitted to go this far due to the unlawful nature of the victims and their propensity toward violence, particularly to the officers. Both cases were settled in the courts, and both exonerated the officers. From here on, the two sagas proceed totally differently. In 2014, when the grand jury opted not to charge the officer, Ferguson burned, 25 buildings destroyed, small businesses were gone, hundreds of jobs lost. This past weekend, when the judge, this was not a jury trial, found the officer not guilty, protesters took to the streets of St. Louis and several small communities surrounding it. The difference is striking. Yesterday, paramilitary vehicles and National Guard. Today, armed police with body armor. Yesterday, fire and destruction. Today, mostly peaceful and very vocal protest. Although, this weekend there appeared to be a trailing faction of troublemakers bent on damaging stuff. Windows and vegetation planters mostly, but no fire, no gunfire. Yesterday, an unclear understanding of the role of law enforcement. Today, the mayor and her police management very clear about what was to be tolerated and what was not. And true civil protest was to be tolerated. Destruction of property was not. Yesterday, virtually 100% black and underprivileged participants. Today, clearly mixed demographics. Conclusion? This year's protests have been better designed to impact more than just the national press. They are more civilly conducted on both sides, protesters and police. At least to this point, far less material damage has been done, although the fear of such damage has closed down many events and negatively affected the short-term economic condition of downtown St. Louis. I see the differences between yesterday, Ferguson, and today, protesters in St. Louis, as an example of fewer and fewer people on both sides trying or even wanting to approach this from their know-or-judge or I'm-right-you're-wrong mindset. Both sides seem more willing to heed each other's messages. Maybe, just maybe, we've migrated a little to a learner-researcher connection. I certainly hope so. What's next? It's Kim, and this is another moment of clarity.